Hello everyone, this is Wasim Sheikh, and in this video tutorial we'll see how to calculate effective stress. To understand this method of effective stress, we'll solve a numerical on this. So this is a statement given to us: compute total effective and pore water pressure at a depth 15 meter below bottom of the lake. So bottom of the lake consists of soft clay with a thickness of 15 meter. The average water content of the clay is 40%. And specific gravity of the soil may be assumed as 2.65. So this is what given to us: a lake 6 meter deep. Below this lake we have 100% saturated clay with a water content 40% and specific gravity 2.65. The depth of the saturated clay is 15 meter. Below this clay layer there is one more layer of hard clay, but we have been asked to determine effective stress 15 meter below the bottom of the lake. So this hard clay layer is irrelevant information and will not consider this in a calculation. Let's start with step 1, that is calculation of saturated unit weight of the clay. To calculate effective stress, we need to have saturated unit weight of the clay, which is not given in the statement. So we'll calculate it. Depending upon data given to us, this is the best possible formula to calculate saturated unit weight. We have the value of G as 2.65, but we don't have value of void ratio E, but we have given relevant data to calculate E. So E can be calculated as water content multiplied by specific gravity G. The water content is 0.4, specific gravity is 2.65. So we have E equals to 1.06, as E is a void ratio and does not have any unit. Now we will have all the data required to calculate saturated unit weight, so that's why gamma sat will be equals to 17.67 kilonewton per meter cube. Now we are ready to proceed to calculate effective stress. Just remember, effective stress is given by total stress minus neutral stress, which is also called as a pore water pressure. So we'll have to calculate both total stress as well as neutral stress, or which is also called as a pore water pressure. Total stress at any section is a product of unit weight of the material and height of that material, and it is denoted by symbol sigma. For better understanding of this numerical, we'll divide the soil profile into two different sections: section 1-1 at the bottom of the lake and section 2-2 15 meter below the bottom of the lake, where we have to calculate final value of effective stress. Now let's calculate total stress at section 1-1. In this case, what will happen? At section 1-1, all the water which is present above the section 1-1, that is inside the lake, will act as a overburden pressure. So therefore, total stress at section 1-1 will be equals to unit weight of the water, that is 9.86, multiplied by height of the water inside the lake, that is 6. Hence, total stress at section 1-1 will be equals to 9.81 multiplied by 6, that is 58.86, and as it is a stress, its unit will be kilonewton per meter square. Similarly, total stress at section 2-2 will be equals to total stress at section 1-1 plus unit weight of the saturated soil, that is gamma sat, multiplied by height of that soil, that is 15. Therefore, total stress at section 2-2 will be equals to 58.86 plus 17.67 multiplied by 15, that is 323.91 kilonewton per meter square. These values are represented in the form of total stress diagram as shown over here. Now let's move on to our next step and calculate the neutral stress. Neutral stress at any section is a product of unit weight of water and piezometric head, and it is denoted by symbol sigma mu, or sometimes just mu. The most important thing to remember about neutral stress is that it only occurs inside a soil which is 100% saturated, which in our case it is. If, let's imagine for the sake of argument, if soil is not 100% saturated, it will not have any kind of neutral stress. In case of partially saturated soil, neutral stress only happens due to capillary rise. So this is beyond our scope of this numerical, so we'll not discuss this. Maybe in future I'll make another video on that. But for the time being, just remember, neutral stress only occurs inside a soil which is 100% saturated. Okay, so therefore neutral stress at section 1-1 will be given by sigma mu 1-1 is equals to 9.81 multiplied by 6, which is equals to 58.86 kilonewton per meter square. Then again, one more important thing that you should remember over here is that imagine there is no lake water and the soil is 100% saturated, and now you are calculating neutral stress at section 1-1. In the absence of water, the neutral the piezometric height at section 1-1 will be equals to 0. So there will be no pressure. This neutral stress at section 1-1 is coming just because of the lake water. This is very important. You should remember this. Anyways, let's go ahead. Similarly, neutral stress at section 2-2 will be equals to sigma mu 2-2 equals to neutral stress at section 1-1 plus gamma w multiplied by 15, that is equals to 206.01 kilonewton per meter square. This is how we calculate the neutral stress, and neutral stress diagram is shown over here. Let's move on to our last step and calculate the effective stress. Effective stress at a section is given by total stress minus neutral stress, and it is denoted by symbol sigma prime, or some people also call it as a sigma dash. Whatever you would like to call, doesn't matter. Anyways, so effective stress at section 1-1 will be equals to total stress at section 1-1 minus neutral stress at section 1-1. So it will be equals to 58.86 minus 58.86, that is 0. Similarly, effective stress at 15 meter below the bottom of the lake will be equals to effective stress at section 2-2, which we have to calculate in this numerical. So that will be equals to total stress at section 2-2 minus neutral stress at section 2-2. Therefore, sigma prime 2-2 will be equals to 323.91 minus 206.01, which is equals to 117.91 kilonewton per meter square. So this is how we can calculate effective stress inside a soil. Effective stress diagram is drawn by subtracting neutral stress diagram from total stress diagram, and it looks like this. So this is where our numerical ends. If you don't understand anything, please let me know in the comment box. I'll try to reply as soon as possible. As always, thank you for watching my videos. See you guys in the next video tutorial.